morning students. Today we are going to learn about hydrological cycle. Water is one of the most important element for our daily life. Water is useful not only for domestic use, it is very useful for agriculture and industrial purposes. Water is very useful for economic activities. So today we are going to learn about the hydrological cycle.
Hydrological cycle. Water on the earth. About 71% of the earth's surface is covered by water. The quantity of water present on the earth is about 326 million cubic miles. It is hard and visualize this massive quantity of water. Most of the water on the earth is saline and is found on seas and oceans. The salt water constitutes about 97.2% and the fresh water is about only 2.8%. Out of this, 2.8% about and 2.2% is available as surface water and remaining 0.6% as groundwater. From this 2.2% of surface water, 2.15% is available in the form of glaciers and ice caps, 0.01% in lakes and streams, and remaining 0.04% is in other forms. Only about 0.25% of total groundwater of 0.6 can be economically extracted with the present drilling technology. Water resources are very useful or potentially useful to humans. Water in India is available in three sources. First one is precipitation, second one is surface water, and third one is groundwater. Next one is hydrological cycle, water cycle. Hydrological is the science which deals with various aspects of water, such as its occurrence, distribution, and movements, and properties on the planet Earth. Availability of water on the Earth is not uniform. Some places are very rich in water resources, while some other places are poor in water resources. Hydrological cycle is a global sun-drive process where water is transported from ocean to atmosphere, from atmosphere to land, and from land back to ocean. As the quantity of water involved in the cycle is invariable, though its distribution varies over space and time. Evaporation takes place from the surface water and transpiration from the plants. Water vapor gets condensed at higher altitude by condensation, nuclei, and form of clouds. The clouds melt and sometimes burst, resulting in precipitation of different forms. A part of water from precipitation flows over the land is called runoff, and the other part infiltrates and soil, which builds up the groundwater. Hydrological cycle is circulation of water. Hydrological cycle is the circulation of water. It is continuous process and take place naturally. The three important phases of hydrological cycle are: first one is evapotranspiration, precipitation, and runoff. First one is evapotranspiration, precipitation, and runoff. Now let us see what are the components of hydrological cycle. There are six main components in hydrological cycle. First one is evapotranspiration, second one is condensation, third one is precipitation, fourth one is infiltration, and fifth one is percolation, and sixth one is runoff. Evapotranspiration, it is defined as the total loss of water from the earth through evaporation from the surface water bodies and the transpiration from vegetation. In cropped areas, it is difficult to determine the evaporation and transpiration separately. Therefore, it is collectively called as evapotranspiration. Next one is evaporation. Evaporation refers to the process in which the liquid form of water changes into gaseous form. Water boils at 100 degrees Celsius temperature, but it actually begins to evaporate at 0 degrees Celsius, and the process takes place very slowly. Temperature is the prime element which affects the rate of evaporation. There is a positive relationship between the two variables, aerial extent of surface water, wind, and the atmospheric humidity or the other variables which affect the rate of evaporation. Next, we have to learn about the atmosphere. The atmosphere gets nearly 90% of moisture from the ocean, seas, lakes, and rivers through evaporation, and the remaining 10% of the moisture from plants through transpiration. On a global scale, the amount of water gets evaporated is about the same as the amount of water delivered to the earth as precipitation. The process varies geographically as the evaporation is more prevalent over the ocean than precipitation. While other the land, precipitation routinely exceeds evaporation. The rate of evaporation is low during the periods of calm winds than during windy times. When the air is calm, evaporated water tends to stay close to the water body. During windy, the water vapor is driven away and replaced by dry air, which facilitates additional evaporation.